Now it's the insurer's turn to face a hurricane. A whirlwind of claims hit their offices today. The companies say they face the biggest single incident claim in the industry's history.
We've had very many phone calls. We've got to set up a special storm section and brought in extra staff to man the telephones.
Can you actually cope with the number of customers who are calling you to make claims?
Well, we're trying to. As I say, we're sending out a lot of claim forms. We're giving advice to our insureds over the phone and helping them as much as we can. And with the more extensive losses, we're appointing loss adjusters immediately. And so someone will call round and assess the damage, and they will also give our policyholders their advice.
Have you come across anything on anything like the sort of scale?
No, never. No, it is really quite horrendous.
Sun Alliance have already dispatched 20,000 claim forms. Almost 200 staff are processing the details and 50 calls a minute. They reckon one in three of their clients suffered damage. It'll be a further 10 days at least before the insurers know the full extent of the claims they face. But it's reckoned the total household bill alone will be close to £1,000 million. Rail commuting is almost back to normal. Southern regions say they've cleared 5,000 trees off their tracks. Only a few minor lines are now blocked. They've lost £1.5 million in revenue. The underground is also fully reopened. 600 trees had to be shifted. The central line's Epping-Ongar section was worst affected. A quarter of a million people throughout the southeast are still without electricity. Kent and Essex are worst. Restoring damaged power lines is going to cost millions of pounds. Simon Neave on the aftermath of the hurricane for Thames News.